ओम नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पामिला मैम एंड माय टुडेस टॉपिक इज फैराडेज लॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस। फैराडेज लॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस गिव्स द रिलेशन बिटवीन द अमाउंट ऑफ चार्ज पास्ड थ्रू द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट एंड द अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस डिपोजिटेड एट द इलेक्ट्रोड्स। टू लॉज आर देयर फॉर फैराडेज लॉज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस। द फर्स्ट लॉ states that the mass of substance deposited or liberated at any electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of charge passed. So W is the weight of substance and charge is equal to Q. So according to the first law, W is directly proportional to Q, and Q is charge in coulomb, which is equal to current into time. Current is I and time is t, so Q is equal to I into t. So replacing Q with I into t, the equation becomes W is directly proportional to the product of I into t. So we can write W equal to Z into I into T. Z is here proportionality constant and is known as electrochemical equivalent. Now, if I is equal to 1 and T is equal to 1, that means 1 ampere current is passed through the electrolyte for 1 second. Then the mass of metal deposited at electrode W will be equal to Z into 1 into 1, or W will be equal to Z. So from this equation we can get the definition of electrochemical equivalent. The definition of electrochemical equivalent is the mass of substance deposited by passing 1 coulomb of charge or by passing 1 ampere of current for 1 second through the electrolyte. Let's take an example of Z. So when 1 coulomb charge is passed through silver nitrate solution, 0.001118 gram of silver is deposited at the cathode. Let's consider a general equation Mn plus aqueous plus Ne minus equal to Ms. That means Mn plus means metal ions in aqueous state. So after gaining N moles of electrons, it is converted into metal solid. That means during electrolysis, metals gains electrons and deposited at metal solid in the cathode. So now let's take A as atomic mass of M or metal, and N is the valency of metal, and we know that charge of one electron is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So charge on one mole of electron will be charge of one electron into number of moles. So charge of one electron is 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and one moles contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 Avogadro number of molecules. So charge on one electron will be equal charge of one mole of electron will be equal to 96,472 coulomb. Roughly we take this value as 96,500 coulomb, and this is known as 1 Faraday. So now we can see that metal ions, after gaining N mole of electrons, deposits M mass of metals, A mass of metals. So from this equation we can calculate that N into 96,500 coulomb of charge will deposit a gram of metal. So 1 coulomb of charge deposits a by N into 96,500 gram. Simple unitary method I have applied. So according to the first law, 1 coulomb of charge deposit z gram of metal. So z is equal to a by N into 96,500 gram. And a by N we know, this is known as equivalent mass. Mass by valency is equivalent mass. So this is E by 96,500 gram. Then second law of electrolysis. Second law states that when the same quantity of charge is passed through the solution of different electrolytes connected in series, the masses of the substances deposited at respective electrodes are directly proportional to their equivalent masses. Let's explain this with the help of this diagram. So these are two electrolytic cells. In one electrolytic cell, copper sulfate is taken as electrolyte, and in this cell silver nitrate taken as electrolyte. Now these two electrolytic cells are connected in series. Connected in series means the two electrodes of two different electrolytic cells are connected. So first electrode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Then next electrode, which is negative terminal. So this negative terminal, this negative electrode is connected to the positive electrode of the second electrolytic cell. And then negative electrode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. Now copper and silver will get deposited at the cathode in both the cells. So copper will be deposited in this electrolytic cell in cathode, and silver will be deposited in this electrolytic cell in the cathode. Okay, so according to the second law, mass of copper deposited by mass of silver deposited will be equal to equivalent mass of copper by equivalent mass of silver. Now, from the first law, we know that W is equal to Z into Q. So for first electrolyte, W1 is equal to Z1 into Q, and W2 is equal to Z2 into Q. So on dividing this equation, W1 by W2 will be equal to Z1 by Z2, and Z is equal to E by 96,500. So Z1 will be equal to E1 by 96,500 by E2 by 96,500. So after simplifying, the equation becomes W1 by W2 equal to E1 by E2. Now what are the applications of electrolysis? The first application of electrolysis is determination of equivalent masses of the elements. From the second law of electrolysis, we can determine the equivalent masses. Okay, according to this law, masses of metals collected at the respective electrodes are directly proportional to their equivalent masses. Then second application is in electrometallurgy, we can collect the reactive metals. We can isolate the reactive metals like sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, etc. with the help of electrolysis. Then third application in electro refining. Some metals like copper, silver, gold, aluminium etc. These metals can be refined by electrolysis. These we will learn in our 6th unit. So we will study this in detail in 6th unit. And also in electroplating. Electroplating is the process of coating a layer of superior metal over surface of inferior metal. By the help of electrolysis, we can do electroplating. So these are the application of electrolysis.